aquí radio, aquí ceremony radio Prifysgol Cardiff. Good morning and welcome to the City of Cardiff and to the graduation ceremony of Cardiff University. I'm Louise Casella, and it's with great pleasure and a shared sense of pride that as University Director, I welcome you all to today's graduation ceremony. We're here to celebrate our students' achievements, and I'm particularly pleased to welcome parents, family and friends to join in this celebration. Students, today marks a marvellous milestone in your life, as it does in the lives of those who've supported you over the last few years. It's a day to enjoy and to celebrate with those who've been your supporters. And it's good to see that so many family and friends are here today. My job before the formal proceedings get underway is to spend a few moments going through the procedures for the ceremony in the hope that this will enhance your understanding and enjoyment of the day. For those of you receiving an award today, perhaps you thought the hardest part was passing your exams. No, you still have the challenge ahead of you of crossing this stage, shaking hands with the right person, and trying not to seek your award from anybody other than the Vice-Chancellor. Lord Neil Kinnock of Bedwefty will formally open proceedings, and the Vice-Chancellor, Dr. David Grant, will receive you to your award. You will already have met our Chief Marshal, Professor David Williams, and shortly I will be joined here on stage by academic staff, presenters, the proclamation reader, and the President of the Students' Union, Mr. Joel Kyatt. To my right will sit Professor David Skilton, the University's orator, and later he will introduce our Honorary Fellow for today. Honorary Fellowships are awarded at our graduation ceremonies to those who have achieved international distinction in their field. And today, we are honoured to welcome Ms. Barbara Wilding, Chief Constable of the South Wales Police. You'll see that the words used for the various stages of the ceremony are printed in your programme. A presenter will read out the names of the students being admitted to the same award. When each name is called, the student will ascend the stage, walk towards the Vice-Chancellor and shake his hand. Please do so gently. As you can imagine, shaking hands with some 6,000 of you over graduation days does take its toll. While past experience has shown this simple process to be sometimes a little more challenging for some than it sounds, your approach to the stage will be guided by our marshals, as will your reseating. So please don't worry. Once it gets started, it really is a case of follow my leader. When you leave the stage, you'll stand with your group facing the Vice-Chancellor, who will formally receive you to your awards. You'll doff in reply, and you'll then be reseated by the marshals. When all awards have been received, students will be asked to stand to receive the university's greetings. I'm sure I don't have to remind you that St. David's Hall is non-smoking. Can I also ask how many of you have your mobile phones with you today? If so, can I ask you to check your pockets, check your handbags, and just make sure they're switched off or switched to silent, please? We will be providing some musical entertainment later in the ceremony. I can assure you it will be better than anything your combined ringtones can produce. Please do check that your phones are off or your phones are silent. This is a day of celebration, and your cheers and applause for your loved ones are welcome and encouraged. Please do make lots of noise. But can I ask you to save that acclaim only for after the Vice-Chancellor has admitted each group of graduates, and not as each one crosses the stage. This will ensure that your hands and voices are still functioning by the end of the ceremony and you get out in time to have a nice lunch. The ceremony will now proceed with the road procession of academic staff led by the Chief Marshal. Thank you for listening. Enjoy your day, enjoy the ceremony, and be proud.
Good morning. Welcome to Cardiff and to St. David's Hall. For it are Croeso I Gaerdydd a'r Naiad Dewi Sant. As President of the University, it's my great pleasure to welcome you to this graduation ceremony, or congregation as it's more properly called. And I extend particularly warm greeting to parents and partners and others whose love and support for those graduating today will have made a major contribution to their success. I also offer my personal congratulations to the people who are graduating. I rejoice at your achievement, and you can be absolutely certain that the qualification that you've earned in this university will be respected not just in the United Kingdom, but right across the whole world. That reputation that Cardiff enjoys has been earned over many years, and to maintain the attributes of success, the university continues its commitment to advances in learning provision with, for instance, £50 million worth of fresh investment just in the last year, spread across high technology, student accommodation and innovative facilities across a wide variety of study disciplines. Such developments also reinforce Cardiff's standing as one of Britain's leading research-led universities. We are now officially ranked 7th out of 106 institutions in the United Kingdom for the quality of research done here, and as a consequence, we've seen a huge rise in research awards to the university in recent years. Our annual income from that source, from competitive research awards, passed £100 million for the first time in 2006, a 21% increase on 2005. And awards went to a great spectrum of activities, from medicine to law, from city planning to philosophy, from maths to theology. And it's performance like that which now puts Cardiff at the top of the global rankings of the best places in the world for postdoctoral work. All these factors have an obvious effect on the attractiveness of this university as a place of learning. This year, we had over 19,000 full-time and 7,000 part-time undergraduate and graduate students. There are no less than 8 applications for every place available in Cardiff. And the overwhelming majority of the people who come here have made this university their first choice. Now, perhaps I should enter an apology for such patent boasting, but frankly, an apology would be somewhat half-hearted on a day of celebration like this, when there is manifestly and objectively so much to be proud of. In any case, I haven't even mentioned several of the other great successes of the university, and therefore I plead mitigating modesty. For instance, I haven't talked about the several designated international centres of excellence in Cardiff University. I haven't mentioned the nationally recognised sporting, cultural and academic achievements of our students, or the national and international prizes, awards and other distinctions given for excellence in research and teaching to our academic staff. And of course, I haven't mentioned the opening this year of the Cardiff International Academy of Voice, one of whose students, Gedi Nimithi, will be entertaining us later. All these and many other attainments that are worthy of acclamation give manifold proof of prowess, proof of advancing standards of opportunity, excellence and innovation, proof of Cardiff's commitment to nourishing the potential of those who come here to learn from all parts and all cultures of the world, and who use their talents to fulfill themselves and to serve the wider interests of humanity. It's those achievements, of course, that we take the greatest satisfaction from, and they're what we celebrate today at this congregation. So, on that subject, I draw your attention to the fact that the procedures and words relating to the various stages of the ceremony are printed in your programme under the relevant heading. As you see, after graduands have been admitted to their qualifications by the Vice-Chancellor of the University, Dr. David Grant, Ms. Louise Casella, the University Director, will ask all graduates and diplomates to stand, and you'll be greeted by myself and by the President of the Students' Union, Mr. Joel Khayat. In the final part of this congregation, the orator of our university, Professor David Skilton, will introduce Ms. Barbara Wilding, Chief Constable of the South Wales Police Force, who is receiving an honorary fellowship from Cardiff University in recognition of her great professional distinction and the valued contribution which she makes to the well-being of society, locally, nationally, and further afield. During the proceedings, I'd be obliged if you'd applaud only after the Vice-Chancellor has admitted each group of graduates to their degrees, not as each one crosses the stage. Now, I know that such restraint can be difficult on a day like this, but time constraints and our concern for the health of your hands plainly make that restraint necessary. And before I conclude, probably for the second time you've heard it this morning, but we can't say it too often, I intone the modern litany. Please turn off your mobile phones. Babies crying and sobs of joy from relieved parents are completely natural on occasions like this, but ringing telephones are not. I thank you all for your attention, and I trust that you'll enjoy this marvellous ceremony.
Gwybodaeth, a nation's strength is in its learning. Boed hysbys I holl aelodau'r brifysgol ac ar hyd a lled y byd, fod cynulliad y brifysgol Caerdydd yn cael ei gynnar heddiw ym Mhrifddinas Cymru. O dan awdurdod siarter frenhinol y brifysgol, mae'r cynulliad hwn yn cyfarfod I dderbyn y myfyrwyr sydd yn rhinwedd eu hastudiaethau a'u hysgol heigdod wedi haroli'n briodol yn unol â statudau'r brifysgol ac wedi cael yn deilwng o'i graddau. Wrth athlu llwyddiant yr rhai sy'n graddio yn y cynulliad hwn, fe hatgoffwn o'i cyfrifoldeb I gyfrannu o werthoedd y brifysgol hon. Nod ydynt hwy yw ceisio drwy eu cyflawniadau wasanaethu a'u lles pawb, ymdrechu I sicrhau rhagoriaeth ym mhob peth ac yn boeni am ddyfodol ein byd. Gwrandewch yn awchus ar ddoethineb, gan ei fod yn cynnig gobaith a gwirionedd ym mhob cenhedlaeth. Nerth Gwlad eu gwybodaeth, a nation's strength is in its learning. Let it be known to all members of the university and throughout the world that today in the capital city of Wales, a congregation of Cardiff University is taking place. Under the authority of the university's Royal Charter, this congregation meets to receive those students who by virtue of their studies and scholarship have been appropriately examined according to the statutes of the university and found worthy of their degrees. We celebrate the success of those who graduate in this congregation, and in doing so, remind them of their responsibility to share in the values of the university. It is for them to seek through their achievements to serve the common good, to strive for excellence in all things, and care for the future of our world. Be attentive to wisdom, for it offers hope and truth in every generation.
I, Professor Terry Marsden, introduce those who have received the degree of Bachelor of Science. Lee Arthur. Luke Christopher Brettingham. Daniel Paul Brooker. Laura B. Taylor. Claudia Elizabeth Clement. Danielle Collins. Philip Cottray. Gwendolyn Elias. Catherine Victoria Erskine. Thomas John Evans. Anna Hagen. James Hamlin. Matthew James Hill. Karen Hudley. Paul Stephen Jarvis. Amy Bethan Sarah Jones. Dylan Llewellyn Jones. Erin Fon Jones. Alison Louise Knight. Victoria Lane. Gemma Louise McCowan. Charles Owen Pierce. Jessie Scharf. Andrew Graham Shepherd. Helen Elizabeth Thorpe. Emily Sarah Vine. Alicia Whitthread. Gwyneth Williams.
Borida, good morning. At this point in the ceremony, and at other equivalent times, it is a tradition of the university for the Vice-Chancellor to speak in Welsh to receive each group of graduates to their awards. The Welsh phrase I will use, when translated, means, through the authority conferred upon me by the university, I receive you to the degree, which I will name, and to all the privileges of that degree. Rwy awdurdod afrifasgol a ymddiriedwyd I mi derbaniach chwi I radd baglor mewn gwyddoniaeth ac I hoch ffreinio rahon. Congratulations.
Matthew Lee Annen. Rebecca Jane Bailey. Nicholas Jeffrey Beckley. Edward James Bright. Simon Charles Clement. Sarah Joanne Dowd. Suzanne Edgar. Philip James Elias. Alistair Mark Evanson. Kathleen Shear Foster. Matthew Giles. Claire Therese Golden. Paul James Gregory. Stefan John Harries. Laura Linton Harry. David Jeffrey. Catherine Jean Jones. Elian Wynne Jones. Hugh Jones. Ross Peter Lovell. Alexander Hugh Paul Milton. Jason Gavin Price. Ian Elliott Ralph. Luke Stephen Seaborn. Christopher Giles Searle. Stephen Sue. Victoria Jane Sloman. Richard Temple. Charlotte Amy Jennifer Westwood. Nicholas Grant.
Pwy awdurdod a brifysgol a ymddiriedwyd i mi derbyniad chwi i rodd baglor mewn gwyddoniaeth ac i hoff Frenia Rojo. Congratulations. I, Professor Martin Kamen, introduce those who have received the degree of Bachelor of Arts. David John Colwell. Victoria Ellen Andrews. Rebecca Amelia Cuff. Guy Dowling. Joseph Dunkley. Vicky Louise Maplebeck. Angel Melissa Middleton. Karina Palmer. Sarah Elizabeth Prendergast. Alison Prosser. Ellen Greer Finlayson Spencerly.
Michael Wench. David John Hoare. Michelle Linsky. Christopher John Mueller. Matthew Gordon Neal. Rowena Vassallo. Orla Catherine Moran. Sarah Emma Day. Rhiannon Heather Fitzgerald. Emma Louise Smith. Gerald Anthony Blee. Fern Bolwell. Lyndon Amy Sherriff.
Rwy awdurdod a brifysgol a'r ymddiriedwyd I mi derbania chwi I radd baglor yn y celfyddydau ac I hoff ffrania brachon. Congratulations.
Christopher John Allen. Camilla Arnhoff. Thomas Joseph Barnes. Hasnira Begum. Jaspreet Bummar. Laura Jean Challoner. Hannah Sapnar Sharn. Emma Louise Chickets. Samantha Caroline Kreese. Mark James Leonard Curzon. Alice Day. Lisa Edwards. Richard Michael Fitzsimmons. Laura Haley Jane Grattan. Joanne Elizabeth Groom. Benjamin Harry Haig. James Damien Harper. Rachel Louise Harris. Charlene Helston. Catherine Ann Hewitt. Helen Hocknell. Sarah Jane Iverson. Katie Elizabeth Jones. Sophie Catherine Claire Leggett. Rian Elizabeth Lewis.
Rwy awdurdod a brifysgol a ymddiriedwyd I mi derbaniaf chwi I radd baglor yn y celfyddydau ac I hoff ffrania brachon. Congratulations.
Bethan Joy Lopp. Helen Lowther. Barney Machen. David Sankar Menon. James Meredith. Roxanne Lauren Mummery. Rachel Louise Oram. Jack Parsons. Kelly Phillips. Eleanor Mary Power. Sean Daniel Price. Alistair James Randall. Michael Richards. Felicity Sarah Robinson. Katie Louise Sell. Aisha Sadiqa. Katie Stewart. Rebecca Lucy Sutton. Jessica Judy Swinburne. Katie Louise Trithui. Esme Patricia Turner. Ansonia Gina Wong. Amira Abu Hashif.
Rwy awdurdod a brifysgol a ymddiriedwyd i mi derbynia chwi i radd baglwr yn y celfyddydau ac i hwch frania rahon. Congratulations.
Andrew John Anderson. Lucy Victoria Andrew. Sarah Rachel Atkins. Stephen Bates. Catherine Bailey. Sophie Margaret Barfield. Hannah Louise Varner. Jonathan David Barnes. Avelyn Beer. Robert Leslie Beavis. Jessica Benfield. Florence Elizabeth Bennett. Annika Helen Bezic. Rachel Bazant. Claire Louise Bisset. Rachel Bloomfield. Mafanwe Jennifer Bowring. Catherine Brennan. Thomas Edward Bromley. Charlotte Jane Brooks. Francesca Louise Bryan. Camilla Sheena, back to one second. Johanna Laura Butler. Katie Anna Byrne. Georgina Grace Elizabeth Carr. Jennifer Claridge.
Rwy awdurdod a brifysgol a ymddiriedwyd i mi derbyniaf chwi i radd baglor yn y celfyddydau ac i hoff ffrania rahon. Congratulations.
Amanda Louise Clark. Laura Ann Clements. Jonathan Brian Douglas Constable. Rosanna Eva Beth Cooper. Thomas Scott Copen. Rachel Emery Cormacan. Katrina Charlotte Corner. Hanharid Rachel Crank. Hannah Rebecca Davis. Rachel Davis. Sarah Louise Davis. Candice Noel DeMille Knight. Sarah Elizabeth Dickinson. Emma Deneen. Georgina Louise Easton. Victoria Jane Evans. Gemma Louise Everson. Rachel Catherine Farrar. Claire Louise Margaret Fisher. Laura Foster. Ryan Guider. Katie Louise Garner. Michael Andrew Gilbert. Claire Helen Gilliland.
Rwy awdurdod a brifysgol a ymddiriedwyd i mi derbyniaf chwi i radd baglor yn y celfyddydau ac i hoff ffrania rahon. Congratulations.
Gemma Susan Godzich. Gavin John Goodwin. Jenny Guthridge. Agnes Hall. Hannah Patricia Hahn. Jenna Louise Harris. Natalie Ruth Harris. Nicole Elizabeth Harris. Rachel Harris. Abigail Diana Harrison. Amy Marguerite Harrison. Daniel Joel Hartley. Dana Hashem. Julie Elizabeth Hatch. Stephanie Ann Horton. Samantha Heron. Rebecca Holly Hudson. Elizabeth Hope. Amy Eleanor Hughes. Christopher John Hughes. Rebecca Hutchin. Alice Sarah Jones. Guab Henryn Jones. James Elliot Jones.
Rwy awdurdod a brifysgol am ddiriedwyd i mi derbyniad chwi i rar baglor yn y celfyddydau ac i hoff ffrenio rathom. Congratulations.
Janine Jones. Rachel Elizabeth Jones. Rhea Louise Jones. Lucy Helen Joyce. Thomas Calix Capella. Laura Alice Kenwright. Cheryl Marie King. Elizabeth Jane Chester King. Elise Natalie Kirk. Yolanda Kopinski. Lara Lane. Giles Alexander Langston. Dean Thomas Lloyd. Carolyn Mandy. Catherine Matthews. Helen Rachel McCullough. Nicola Jane Minaj. Catherine Allison Miles. Ruth Emily Miller. Shamina Mohammed. Rachel Elizabeth Moore. Joanna Sophie Moorman. Olivia Morthy. Eleanor Redpath Morris.
Rwy awdurdod a brifysgol a ymddiriedwyd I mi derbyniad chwi I radd baglor yn y celfyddydau ac I hoff frenia rachon. Congratulations.
Faye Rosina Mosley. Craig Noons. Kim O'Connor. Jessica Payne. Andrew Tristan Pike. Danielle Francis Pitcock. Joanna Elizabeth Plummer. Rosie Ponting. Nardine Melissa Preedy. Doreen Purser. Saizlina Rahim. Ian John Ravenscroft. Andrew David Renison. Sophie Pasquale of Robebe. Laura Rowe. Ashley Victoria Ryman. Bethan Sean Samuel. Emily Shepherd. Rebecca Ann Schillerbeer. Alana Marie Simmons. Sally Jane Smallman. Kate Suzanne Smith. Michelle Jane Smith. Catherine Ann Snell.
Rwy awdurdod a brifysgol a ymddiriedwyd I mi derbyniad chwi I radd baglor yn y celfyddydau ac I hoff frenia rachon. Congratulations.
Alexandra Christina Sorensen. Lucy Spencer. Joanna Ruth Spooner. Sean St. John. Elizabeth Stevens. Hannah Mary Sugden. Sophia Isabel Teal. Alan Diane Thomas. Helen Thompson. Amy Rebecca Townsend. Neil Ashley Turner. Edward Vanston. Jade Louise Watson. Jenny Lloyd Webster. Sarah Wheatcroft. Roseanne Kathleen White. John Gibson Whittles. Julia Caroline Willem. Amy Williams. Kirsty Elizabeth Williams. Rebecca Williams. Jennifer Willis. Louise Sarah Wright. Kate Elizabeth Allen.
Rwy awdurdod y Prifysgol a ymddiriedwyd i mi derbyniau chwi i radd baglor yn y celfyddydau ac i hoff frenia rathon. Congratulations.
Robin June Crossy. Michelle Deaney. Victoria Amy Lennon. Laura Jane Safe. Cara Bartley. Jessica Lucy Glantz. Elizabeth Jane Lane. Sarah Louise Ashley. Tara Michelle Benham. Holly Eloise Clements. Patrick George Downing. Sarah Emma Edmonds. Sarah Ann Ewan. Natasha Hall. Ben Hooper. Kate Elizabeth Jackson. Rebecca Fern Manley. Lisa Claire Oxland. Vanessa Elizabeth Pells. David John Pruitt. Danielle Royce. Rhys Edward Tranham. Corrine Williams. Dadeen Anne Ringe.
Trwy awdurdod a brifysgol ymddiriedwyd I mi derbyniau chwi I rhaid baglor yn y celfyddydau ac I hoch frenio rathon. Congratulations.
David Edward Arnold, Andrew Bartlett, Holly Elizabeth James, Oliver Samuel Milburn, Elizabeth Lucy Mitchell, Jennifer Alice Payne, Alid Power, Charlotte Marie Smith, Stephen Caleb Woodbridge, Sally Airy, Claire Elizabeth Bennett, Faye Patricia Bennett, Rebecca Melody Child, Gemma Ellis, Nicholas Richard Hogan, Samantha May Hubbard, Carol Wynne Jones, James Lutchford, Claire Elizabeth Power, Rosamund Smith, Alice Lennon, Mary Charlotte Penson, Elizabeth Peters, Philip William Weston,
Trwy awdurdod a brifysgol ymddiriedwyd I mi derbyniau chwi I rhaid baglor yn y celfyddydau ac I hoch frenio rathon. Congratulations.
Victoria Catherine Green, Hugh Livingston, Sam Lewis Cruz, Claire Elaine Back, Katie Ann Barnes, Madeline Jane Coleman, Rhiannon Harriet Croucher, Olivia Louise Denham, Elizabeth Dobbs, Felicity Down, Narelle Maureen Edwards, Claire Ann Evans, Sarah Louise Evans, Lucy Harden, Kylie Harris. Hazlina Bint Hassan. Jenna Antonia Hopkinson. Sadie Jane Lofthouse. Hannah Mary Luffy. Polly Pounsby. Robert Berwin Price. Pavanjit Sagera. Elizabeth Mary Vickery. Kelly Woolley. Penny Jane Wright. Miriam Sully.
Rwy awdurdod a brifysgol am ddiwrieddwyd i mi derbyniau chwi i radd baglwr yn y celfyddydau ac i hoff ffrenio rohon. Congratulations.
Ruth Alice Clements. Lydia Sarah Jane Denham. Emma Jane Morgan. Lisa Marie Williams. Daniela Giuseppina Vicioni. Nathan Thompson. Rebecca Witchell. Lucy Janet Eleanor Banks. Kerry Ellen Bayliss. Harry Birch. Alexander Jens Brown. Lucy Catherine Cook. George Comersdale. James Donson. Jonathan Lloyd Duggan. David Evans. Melissa Louise Evans. Tom Robert Evans. Nicholas James Fritzrich. Nicholas John Andrew Gordon. Robert Arthur Haywood. Patrick John Howard. Christopher Thomas Kelly. Robert Lang.
Rwy awdurdod a brifysgol am ddiwrieddwyd i mi derbyniau chwi i radd baglwr yn y celfyddydau ac i hoff ffrenio rohon. Congratulations.
Catherine Louise Lee. Anna Sophia Littledale. Katie Moore. Craig Robert Nightingale. Lucy Alice O'Connor. Benjamin Saltmarsh. Joseph Stephen Selman. Rachel Stelfox. Jenny Frances Stringer. Jonathan Nicholas Whitehead. Kirsty Williams. Thomas John Bradley. David Hugh Rees. Nicole Ann Davis. Adam Christopher Edwards. Samuel Edwards. Alvin Shum. Sarah Elizabeth Wade. Lucy Baldwin. Christina Rosemary Trout. Alexandra Claire Justins. Amy Elizabeth Starnes. Rachel Claire Piper.
Truly, our dear God, Abrivascol, am dear yet weed in me, Derbaniab Hui, Irar, Baglor, and a Calvadadai, a key hawk, Frenya Rathon. Congratulations.
Professor Teresa Rees introduced those who have received the degree of Master of Arts. Merrin Laura Evans. Anne-Marie Bruner. Georgia Elavari. Louise Jane Andriwatha. Fiona Mary Bibby. Jake Buckley. Emma Catherine Follett. David Andrew Griffiths. James Heron. Claire Louise Nurden. Merwin Kate Elizabeth Connolly. Sharon Naomi Davis. Elizabeth Galvin. Rebecca Jane Garner. Catherine Gower. Victoria Louise Gibbons. Wendy Sean Graves. Stephanie Claire Hammond. Claire Hunt. Nicola Cara Kinney. Thomas Llewellyn Owen. Jessica Kate Webb. Catherine Marie Williams. Laurie Williams. Kirsty Andrea Winskin. And Melissa Haley Beer.
Trwy awdurdod abrifysgol a amdurdiedwyd I mi derbania chwi I raf athro yn y celfyddydau ac I hoff greinio rahon. Congratulations.
Shevitz, Elizabeth Stradden, Laura Jane Gerard, Samantha Jane Hudson, Elisa Carolyn Joyce, Patrick Gerard McCoy. Ben Roberts, Claire Louise Williams, Jinhui Chen, Catherine Teresa Donaldson, Dawn Elizabeth Matthews. Amy May Lancelot. Amy Jane McKeldon. Christopher John William Scott. Romiana Kim Thomas. Esther Carianne Broom. Lindsay Curtis. Jennifer Ann Heal. Peter Nicholas Kelly. Hannah Susan Knight. Claire Louise Lewis. Shouyan Lu. Robert William Offord. Andrew David Watkins. And Yana Zhang.
Trwy awdurdod abrifysgol a amddiriedwyd I mi derbania chwi I radd athro yn y celfyddydau ac I hoff freinio rahon. Congratulations.
Francis Cajo Amico. Kirsty Ankarad Ellis. Rachel Evans. Hao Yin Fung. Catherine Chinesi Ayapadi. Lindsay Marie Parr. Kate Sinclair. Luke Takuchi. Zhou Yan Chen. Zhou Ying Ma. Ishita Sheh. Shahawanaz Ahmed Shashir. Akshat Pippin. Sum Yi Wong. Christina Joanna Andrus. Catherine Patricia Brett. Gemma Christie. Benjamin Saul Clark. Robert James Davis. Gemma Delves. And Hannah Tamsin Fortune.
Trwy awdurdod afrifasgol a ymddiriedwyd i mi derbyniaf chwi i roi'r athro mewn gwyddoniaeth ac i holl ffrengau rochon. Congratulations.
Introduce those who have received the degree of Master of Science. Claire Dorothy Fowler. Andrew Robert Francis. Rodri David Griffiths. Wayne Grimstead. Peter Romney Thomas Grubb. Jonathan James Harris. Thomas Andrew Horn. Helen Lisa Claire Inman. Daryl Jones. Justin Jones. Randa Jordan. Jane Elizabeth Lamnier. Sho Li Lu. Ginny Mitten. Claire Marion O'Donovan. Mary Bridget O'Shaughnessy. Emma Suzanne Parsons. Jessica Faye Potter, and Rachel Ann Reed.
Rwy awdurdod a brifysgol am ddiwriedwyd i mi derbynia chwi i radd athro mewn gwyddoniau ac i hoch ffreiniau rathon. Congratulations.
Mark Alexander Stringer, Brian Swain, Catherine Ann Benton, Kelly Louise Collins Thomas, Jeanette Margaret Horrott, Nina Ingrid Jones, Unquan Karen Lee, Rachel May Fern Lynn, Amy Helen Lowther, Jonathan Paul Markwell, Christopher Martin, Thomas Charles Oswald, Timothy John Pierce, Alexander Ian Robinson, Susie Rolls, Jonathan David Rowlett, Chloe Alexandra Sinton, Haley Spender, Octavia Stott,
Rwy awdurdod a brifysgol a ymddiriedwyd i mi derbyniau chwi i radd athro mewn gwyddoniau ac i hoch ffreiniau rathon. Congratulations.
Elizabeth Angela Louise Dignan, Emma Louise Joyce, Robert Morehouse, Stephen Owen, Adeline Anna Santos, Owen Magnus Struthers, Christopher Williams, Sharif Salah Owen, Genevieve Besharat, Edward John Bradford, Joseph Cassinelli, Laura Ann Farag, Hugh Brian Gallagher, Christopher Glyn Goodall, Richard Lewis Jones, David Kinch, Ying Lai, Abiba Nasanga Isabuga, Stephen John Phillips, Awil Sharif Salah, Alexander Silva, Zudan Tan, Philip Carrick Trenham Weatherhead, and Krishna Kadam.
Rwy awdurdod a brifysgol a ymddiriedwyd i mi derbyniad chwi i ra athro mewn gwyddoniaeth ac i hoch frenio rath hon. Congratulations.
Professor Teresa Rees introduced those who have received the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Helen Elizabeth Barnard. Charlotte Boyce. Rosamond Elaine Brennan. Sophie Kate Donaldson, Gareth Gordon, Diane Hemmings, Rachel Akinesi Hurdley, Ian Johnson, Cecilia Joseph, Catherine Ann Monagle, Katie North, Alva Myra Thunder,
Rwy awdurdod a brifysgol a ymddiriedwyd i mi derbyniad chwi i radd doethur mewn athroniaeth ac i hoff ffrenia rahon. Congratulations.
Well, well done, you did it. Made it across that stage, shook hands with the right person and found a seat afterwards. Congratulations. Can I invite all of you who've received your awards this afternoon to stand so that you can receive the greetings of the President, Lord Neil Kinnock of Bedwathy, and the President of the Students' Union, Mr. Joe L. Kyatt.
Boyd Eich Gofal ac Anhrydydd, Drosmwydd ac Anhrydydd Ein Prifysgol a'r Ffes Ein Byd. May your care ever be for the success and good name of our university and the well-being of our world.
You are now members of the distinguished alumni of this university. May your association with the university be cherished and be constant throughout your life, and may your care forever be for the fellowship of our university and the welfare of all people. And can I personally thank you all for supporting the Students' Union not only this year but throughout your time here at Cardiff. Diolch yn fawr.
Before you sit down, I'm sure all you very proud graduates would like to join in a long-standing university tradition, and that is to pay a special tribute to your families and friends, and indeed to the academic staff who've supported you, whether academically, emotionally, or no doubt financially, over many years, and who've helped you reach this important point in your life today. Can I invite you all then to turn around to greet your family and friends, or if they couldn't be with you, to wave to the cameras at the webcast, and say a special and very public thank you by giving them all a big wave, a huge cheer, and an enthusiastic round of applause. Thank you very much. Please be seated.
Vice-Chancellor, although Barbara Wilding is the first woman Chief Constable of South Wales, women are now reaching the top far more often than they used to. Yet there has been a second line of defence of the male bastion and operation, whereby women have been allowed to rise, but expected to rise through such specialities as community policing. Our Chief Constable, sir, broke with that practice, as a brief account of her career will show. In 1971, she transferred to the Metropolitan Police from the relative peace of the state's police in Jersey, having joined there as a cadet in 1967, and in the Metropolitan Police, she served as an operational detective throughout London and on specialist units in New Scotland Yard. She became an assistant chief constable in Kent Constabulary in 1994 with responsibility for personnel, and in 1997 took command of Crime Operations Intelligence and European Liaison. In 1998, she transferred back to the Metropolitan Police as deputy assistant commissioner and served in personnel and in specialist operations, where she commanded the Security and Protection Directorate, which has responsibility for the protection of ministers and the royal family, and for Special Branch, Heathrow Airport, Covert Intelligence, and Specialist Firearms Unit. Unsurprisingly, sir, she came to Wales with a reputation for independence of mind, and we soon found in her a willingness to stand a little apart from the Whitehall line, for example, in her view of ASBOs as a last resort and not a panacea. She combines her experience in some of the toughest areas of policing with a focus on local communities, believing that the case for community regeneration is compelling, and seeing a key role for herself as a builder of personal relationships between partner agencies and the communities they serve. This attitude is manifest, for example, in her support of the multi-agency partnerships that support those affected by domestic violence. Barbara Wilding, who is a co-director of the Police National Assessment Centre and oversees a national mentoring scheme for female superintendents, is herself a graduate in criminology from London University. So it is fitting that she has fostered links with Cardiff University, in particular the foundation of the University Police Science Institute. Policing is to be kept up to date less by graduate-only recruitment than by upgrading qualifications in the creation of an all-graduate force. A companion of the Chartered Management Institute, a member of the Royal Institute for International Affairs and of the Royal College for Defence Studies, Barbara Wilding was awarded the Queen's Police Medal in the Millennium Awards 2000 and was created Commander of the British Empire in 2006. Antre Davis is gang heslot, Kavuina Viti, Barbara Wilding, Vel Cymraud, Eren Radev, Prifysgol Caerdydd.
Awdurdod a roddwyd i mi gan y cyngor derbyniadu fel Cymrawd Eran Fradedd, Prifysgol Caerdydd.
President, Vice-Chancellor, ladies and gentlemen, and those being admitted to their various degrees today. Prynhawnda, and I shall stop there because my Welsh is not particularly good. However, like so many things that we're trying to achieve in Wales, I'm trying to learn Welsh, and in Wales we're moving forward at a very fast rate of knots, some of it you've heard about this morning. I would just like to concentrate for a moment on you, the people who have achieved today. One of the great privileges of being a chief constable is being invited quite often to schools to give awards to sixth form and occasionally to ceremonies such as these. I have to say, never have I had the privilege of being in this position. And I'd really like to say to the Vice-Chancellor, the President, and the Council of the University, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity, and I, of course, accepted with a great deal of alacrity. Why do I like going to events where young people are celebrated? Well, you know, we see in the press all the time these days the demonisation of young people. So opportunities to celebrate success and achievement are great. We don't see them in the papers very often. But we, as parents and loved ones of young people, know that you achieve a great deal. You are successful now. You will have been role models for quite some time. And you go on now into your chosen fields, and you'll be role models again. And that brings responsibilities, huge responsibilities, because you are really now building your personal legacy. I say to my staff that their greatest personal legacy is the future prosperity of Wales. Why do I say that? Because we are the largest force in Wales. We have 42% of the population in Wales. Our role is, through enforcement, to make the place secure. But working with our partners in planning, in health, in communication, and so many of the areas and disciplines that I've seen this morning come up on the stage, working with you is to keep the place stable and secure. Because only then, and only then, can we have economic regeneration. Can we have people willing to come and invest in an area? Because through all our efforts, it looks safe, it feels safe, and it is safe. And they know that their staff in their factories or offices are likely to travel to work on a transport system that will run on time if it's not been vandalised, that people are not robbed using those systems, and that their premises are unlikely to be burgled. And there's a lot to be said about how those premises are built. So those of you in planning and design have a huge responsibility to the future in using your acquired skill and knowledge if you choose to go into that particular profession. But a last thought I'd like to leave you with. I say wherever I go that we should not demonise young people. We should never give up hope on them. But most of all, we must listen to young people. Most of you here today are very close to young people. You can hear what they're saying. You can interpret what they're saying, be it in your workplace and the skills that you now have achieved from this wonderful university. But equally, you as a person, you're a successful person, each and every one of you. You're achievers. And I've no doubt, with the background of having been at this university, the friends, professional relationships you will have made, you will carry on being hugely successful. Please, I just ask you, when you leave here, use some of that success to make sure we live in a civil society and that you contribute to that civil society, both professionally and personally, so that your personal legacy is truly outstanding. And to the parents and loved ones who've supported you all through this time, I'd like to say thank you very much indeed for helping young people achieve their ambitions and to help make us this much better civil society. You've all contributed. Diolch yn fawr.
Vice Chancellor, honorary fellow, ladies and gentlemen, it's now a very great pleasure for me to introduce to you from the University's Cardiff Academy of Voice, a young tenor from Romania who is one of the Academy's students, Gerie Nimeti, accompanied by Jane Samuel. With pleasure, Gerie.
Thank you.
a Romanian tenor comes to the capital city of Wales in order to sing in Italian and delight us. I think this globalization is starting to work in the right way. Ladies and gentlemen, as president of the university, it now falls to me to bring these proceedings to a close. Naturally, this occasion is one of the most pleasurable in the university calendar, indeed in life itself. And it is a real joy to see the graduates walk across this platform with pride and some relief. It's also a matter of astonishment to me, especially so far as the young women are concerned, because they have these extraordinary contraptions on their feet and how they manage to make it. In normal life, I suppose, that's mastered easily, but when you've got to carry one of these damn things on your head as well and do it with poise, it's always extremely impressive. And we didn't have a single accident. Nobody ricked their ankle. Nobody dropped their mortarboard. One or two of the young men did say cheers to the Vice Chancellor as if he'd bought them a drink instead of giving him a degree. And there were one or two winks at the same time. Why we men feel obliged to wink when we're in circumstances like this. Though I did hear for the first time in a lot of these ceremonies I've been to this morning something I haven't heard before. Several of the young women with great grace walked up and said to the Vice Chancellor, "Hi." I haven't come across that one before. I'll be watching out for that in future. But it's been a wonderful occasion, as it invariably is. I never tire of the feeling of uplift, of encouragement, of optimism that comes on these occasions. And to the people who've graduated today, I say, I hope you take with you happy memories of your time in Cardiff. I hope that you feel confident that your studies in this university have been a valuable contribution to your lives and your careers. And I hope that you're determined to use your talents to your maximum potential, both naturally for your own fulfillment and also for the benefit of your fellow human beings everywhere. To us, of course, you will always be Cardiff people. I trust that you'll be proud to carry that identity wherever you go. I hope that you'll be willing to keep in touch with our alumni organization and also ready to use the advantages of belonging to it and being therefore part of a worldwide network of people with a deep and, I hope, affectionate association with Cardiff University and the city. To everyone who's graduated today, I wish you good fortune, good health, and every success in the future. Llong gyfalchiadau, iechyd da, a phob llwyddiant i bob un. Diolch yn fawr iawn.